Welcome to MCN, I'm Ian Jubb, staff photographer, and this is my long-term test bike for the year, the Ducati Diavel. Right, so I've had the bike since the end of April this year, and so far I've covered 3,000 miles in all different conditions, in the dry, in the wet, touring to France, done a couple of track days, general blasts out of weekends with mates and to a few bike nights. So, modifications I've made to the bike. There's only a couple of things so far, and to be honest, there's not really that many things you can do because it's already pretty damn good at what it does. The first thing was the Ohlins rear shock. That's £1,200 shock specifically designed for this bike. It replaces the entire shock and the preload adjuster, which is a nicely machined bit of aluminium, just a bit of bling. It's just incredible. It's transformed the ride quality. It turns nicer, keeps the front end down better in first and second. The ride height is slightly higher as well, so you don't find it grinding out on roundabouts and tight corners quite as much. Second thing is the full Termignoni system, which, to be honest, is more for aesthetics than anything. It doesn't need it. It doesn't need it at all. It's not like it's lacking in power at 162 horse. I think it's made it to about 172 now. It's just kind of purely to let it breathe a little bit and really release the sound of the V-twin that's kind of held back by the cat, as with all modern bikes. Right, so other than the number plate hanger having the recall, there's only a couple of tiny minor niggles that I have. One is the swing arm. I have large feet, size 14, and my heel rubs the swing arm a tiny bit. It's kind of started to go through the paint a little bit. I guess I could put some sort of protector on there. I imagine Ducati probably will in later models. The other thing is the headlight switch. It's down for on and pull for flash. And the problem I have is when I return to the bar, say after thanking a motorist on an overtake, I put my hand back on and it pushes it onto main beam. I find myself going along with the headlight blazing before I realise, which annoys motorists to say the least, but that's just something I've got to get used to by remembering to put my hand further along the bars. Other than that, no problems whatsoever. Just, it's great. Just never skips a beat. Never a problem starting. No issues whatsoever. Fantastic. A couple of other bits I've changed. One is the Ducati Performance frame plugs. Pretty much for looks, but also do serve a bit of a practical purpose of stopping dirt getting in there, which is normally a hollow and building up. And the other thing is the reservoir caps, which have now got carbon fiber. Yeah, again, Ducati Performance parts. They're just needless bling, but they look cool. I think the main thing with it is people need to realise it looks like a cruiser, it's not really a cruiser. As Phil West said in February on the launch, it's kind of defined its own genre. It's not a sports bike, it's not a cruiser, it's somewhere in between. So it is hard, it is a hard ride. It's not ever going to be a super smooth ride. It's not that kind of bike. It's a Ducati at the end of the day. It's all about performance. Performance is at its heart, and the style and what it can do kind of comes after that. You know, it's still got to be fast on the brakes and on the gas. That's just the way it is. But I think if you're active with the modes, you'll definitely get the best out of it. You know, stick it in urban mode when you're in town. Stick it in sport mode when you're on a blast with your mates. Stick it in touring mode when you've got a pillion, or if you just want to take it steady, it just softens it out a little bit, and then it'll come into its own. So there we go, that's my long-term test report so far. I know it seems a bit too good to be true, but it really is a fantastic bike. I really don't have that many problems with it, and it hasn't had any problems itself. If you have any comments or questions, leave them below or get in touch via the website.